Hello everyone, this is day 18 of the ARD question series, and as I told you in the previous video that I'll be discussing about the topic irrigation and the questions related to it. So do watch the video till end, as there's one question at the end of the video which you need to tell in the comment section. So the first question is, the artificial application of water to partially meet the crop requirement is known as. So in a very simple terms, this question is asking about or telling you about the definition of irrigation. The application of the controlled amount of water to the plants as and when they required, or basically at the needed intervals, then it is known as irrigation. So irrigation is providing the water to the crops as per their requirement. Nothing much to discuss. Let's look at other questions as well. So the next question is, flood irrigation, check basin and furrow method, these are the types of. So there are different types of irrigation methods, like the sprinkler method, surface method, drip irrigation, trickle irrigation, drip and trickle are same, and subsoil irrigation. These are different methods of irrigation. But there are subcategories as well. So under which categories we classify these flood irrigation, check basin and furrow method. So these three come under the surface irrigation. So what does surface irrigation mean? So surface irrigation, in very simple terms, if you need to classify, the flooding of the land with the water. It is just by the gravity, or we could say that it's kind of uncontrolled flooding, that is known as the surface irrigation. Now there are different methods as well, because we cannot always use the unflooding irrigation. So we need to check or control the flow of water as well. Now there are different methods, as I just mentioned, flood irrigation, check basin and furrow method. So flood irrigation is known as uncontrolled flooding. So what happens in uncontrolled flooding is that the water is applied to the crop land without any preparation of the land. So where the area is, or the topography is irregular, the surface is irregular and the availability of water is more, there we use this flood irrigation method. So without any restrictions or guidance, the water flows. That is known as the flood irrigation. As the name suggests, uncontrolled flooding, that is the part of flood irrigation. Next being the check basin. So check basin is, this is the example of check basin, where the field is divided into number of almost leveled plots. So these are the leveled plots in which the field has been divided and the water is admitted to these plots turn by turn. So first the water would be given to this panel, then to this panel. So this is how the water, the controlled amount of water is being flown. Now this is somewhat the good method or good method of surface irrigation. Why? Because the farmer can control. So there, in this flood irrigation, there is, as the name suggests, it's uncontrolled method and the availability of water should be high. But at the same time, the water is not available in that abundance, then we can use the controlled method of irrigation, that is check basin. Also there is basin method at the same time, where there are one basin which is made for the particular crop. So if this is the tree, this one basin is made. So this is the field, suppose this is the field. So different basins are created which are being flooded with the water for particular crop. So this is known as the basin method. And if we combine these methods, these are check basins. So one by one the water would be given to these basins. Next one being the furrow method. This picture represents the furrow method. So what is furrow method? It is an alternative to the flooding method. Why? Because the entire land surface is being constructed with the, or the entire land is converted into small channels along the primary direction of the movement. So let's decide that the water would be flown from this direction. This is the water flowing area. So these are created, these are the channels which have been created in the whole farm. Thus the water flows in these channels or through these channels, which are known as furrows. Now one disadvantage, or there are certain disadvantages of this method. One being that it leads to the soil erosion. Why soil erosion? So near the upstream, this area near the upstream or end of the field, the soil erosion can be held. At the same time, it affects the salinity of the soil at this upstream area or the up end of the field. But still, if the water is available in abundance, then we can use the surface irrigation. We'll be discussing about these different types of irrigation in the next questions. So let's look at the next question. Drip irrigation is also called as trickle irrigation. Now this is type of a localized irrigation, or it is a method of micro irrigation. It's important to remember, a question can come on this, and the question was there in the previous examination as well. So the type of a localized irrigation or micro irrigation, in which the drops of the water, is if you can see, there are droplets of the water which are delivered near the roots of the plant. So this is where the droplets of water would be. So if you can see, the droplets of water would be given at this area. Now, why is it known as the micro irrigation, or why this method is very important? Because the places where there are is water scarcity, or the water scarce area, this method works wonderful. So the idea of coming with this drip irrigation method, or the main agenda behind coming with this drip irrigation, was because of these two reasons. The one being the water scarcity. So the area where the water is not available in abundance, we can use this drip irrigation, as the each droplet of water is being utilized. Next being the salt problem. So there are various salt problems associated, which actually, so what happens when there is flooding of water, then the salt of the soil gets affected. Therefore, water scarcity and salt of the soil, these are the two major reasons why the drip irrigation was introduced. It is also known as trickle irrigation. Also, this requires an investment on the behalf of farmer. Why? Because this area requires the mechanized instruments or equipments to be installed near the plants. And each and every plant root is being provided with the mechanized equipment. Therefore, they are suitable for the widely spaced crops. So, widely spaced crops is one of the major requirement of this drip irrigation method. Moving on to the next question. So, which method is not suitable in case of the strong windy climate condition? Drip irrigation, as I just mentioned, that the droplets are being given to the roots around the root. So drip irrigation is not affected by the strong windy climate. So it is suitable. Next is the surface irrigation. The water is being flooded in the surface irrigation. Therefore, the climate or the wind would not affect the surface irrigation. Trickle irrigation is another name for drip irrigation. Then, therefore, it is also suitable. Next is the sprinkler irrigation. Now, what is this sprinkler irrigation? If you can see in this picture, this is kind of an artificial rain being created by the sprinkler. So what is happening over here? The water is applied with a pressure to the surface of these crop. You can see that the water is being applied with pressure, and it is being done in the form of the spray. So somewhat resembling rainfall. So this is known as, or sprinkles are being given to the crops. So this is known as sprinkler irrigation, and this method is not advisable in the places where there is strong wind. So the strong windy climate is not suitable for the sprinkler irrigation, because due to the effect of the wind, the water would flow in one direction rather than being sprinkled on the whole farm. At the same time, the rate of the spray can also be regulated, and it is suitable for mostly all the soils and mostly all the crops, but it is not suitable for rice and jute. Remember this thing, it's not suitable for rice and jute, and it is not suitable for the heavy clay soil. So two things to remember in this, that rice and jute, for this the sprinkler irrigation is not suitable. The next being the heavy clay soils, the sprinkler irrigation is not suitable for these kind of soils. The last question is, what is the field application efficiency of surface irrigation? And there was one question last year as well related to drip irrigation. So this data has been taken from the website FAO and Food and Agriculture Organization. And as you can see, that the field application efficiency of these three methods have been given over here. So for surface irrigation, it's 60%. For sprinkler irrigation, it's 75%. And for drip irrigation, it's 90%. So the answer of this question is surface irrigation, 75%. Nothing much to remember, but just to remember the factual information. Now it's time for you to comment. The question is, from which country drip irrigation method was introduced? Don't try to skip these questions, as these questions are related to the agriculture and can be asked in the examination. So do mention in the comment section below that from which country drip irrigation method was introduced. Also, if you haven't watched the previous videos, do watch those videos as well, and do not forget to subscribe to our channel. We'll be coming up with the next video soon. Thank you so much for watching the video.